Did you know that AI agents are changing the world in areas like customer service and writing stories? What if I told you that making your own AI agent is way easier than it sounds? Stay tuned and I'll show you how to build one step by step. An AI agent is a program that can do tasks on its own by understanding and using information. You can find them everywhere, like chatbots or apps that suggest what to watch next. Today I'll help you create your first AI agent, and it's simpler than you think. Starting with AI agents can feel tricky at first. People often wonder, how does it even work? What tools do I need to make one? It's easy to get confused by all the technical terms, but the good news is that you don't need to be an expert or spend years learning this. We will use LangGraph in this case, but there are options like TrueAI, Pydantic AI, etc., which you can use to build a working AI agent with just a little code. Today we'll make a basic AI agent that can do online research, and we'll use Google's latest Gemini 2.0 flash model as the brains for our agent, as that seems to be the latest and greatest at the moment. I'll also tell you how to choose the right model for agentic workflow so that you can make the right choice in the future. So here is what we'll do. We'll install LangGraph Studio as our IDE. The desktop application is only available for macOS at the time of recording this video, but you can use LangGraph CLI, which is platform agnostic. I'll leave a link to their documentation under the video. It needs Docker to be running in the background. I'll start with an absolute bare bones template. I'll leave a link to this repo under the video. It has bare bones files that are required for LangGraph Studio to recognize the directory as a LangGraph project. After I take a Git clone and open that up in LangGraph Studio, I'll also open it up in VS Code. If you want a more in-depth walkthrough on LangGraph framework and LangGraph Studio, then check out this video that I made a couple of weeks ago. Now let's start coding. I'll import the LangGraph pre-built React agent function. Each agent has a model / LLM, a set of tools, and a system prompt. Choosing the right model is crucial in agentic applications. You want to choose a model that is good in tool calling and ideally in multiple tool calling, as well as good in reasoning. Now there is this benchmark called Berkeley's function calling leaderboard that ranks LLMs on their tool calling capabilities. Although I don't think they have been able to rank Google's latest model as it was launched only a few weeks ago, but according to Google's launch article, they have native tool calling capabilities allegedly built to power agentic experiences. Also, when it comes to reasoning, it throws its predecessors out of water, so it should be quite a good choice for agentic applications in my opinion. Going forward, for agentic applications, you want to choose an LLM that ranks high on BFCL v3, indicating multiple function calling capabilities, as well as one that shows good chain of thought reasoning. I'll use Chat Google Generative AI class for this. Add the LangChain Google Gen AI package in the requirements and save. Get an API key from the Google AI Studio. It's free. Save it in the .env file with the name Google API key. Back in your code, create an instance of the class like this. It requires the environment variable, so add the python.env as dependency so as to load the environment variables in the Python runtime. And in the code, I'll import load.env function and the OS at the top, and then load the environment variables by calling the load.env function and set the environment variable in the Python runtime like this. We'll add the LLM instance to the model parameter here in the React agent function, and I'll give it a system prompt. You are a research-driven agent specializing in gathering detailed and accurate information on a given topic. Present your research findings with as much data and numbers as possible. For it to be able to conduct the research, I'll give it an online search tool. Now, here are a few options. DuckDuckGo search is completely free and doesn't even need an API key, but it will eventually hit rate limit when running longer research using this API. I'll leave a link to this page under the video where you can find various options for online research tool. In my case, I'll use Tavily Search. You can get an API key from the website and save it in the environment variable with the name Tavily API key. We'll have to add the LangChain community package as dependency and import the tool from that. I'll create an instance of the tool like this. Like before, we'll have to set the API key in the runtime environment like this. Now we will add this in the tools array and pass the research agent itself as the graph. Now I'll reload the project and ask research on impact of AI on job market. We can see that it uses Tavily tool to fetch information from online and then summarizes the key findings. It talks about tasks that are predictable in nature and going to be replaced and automated. It says that it will create jobs in AI ethics, data science and coding. Jobs will shift from repetitive tasks to innovation and creative problem solving. Skills requiring emotional intelligence, critical thinking, problem solving are less likely to be affected. It also talks about demands in AI development and data analysis and so on and so forth. Now, if you've seen my previous video, then you know that more often than not, we would want to present the research findings using charts. Now, there are a couple of ways of generating the charts. You can create a chart generator agent, which will take these research findings and output a Python code that will show the data using matplotlib subplots. But you can make the chart generator output structured JSON as well that will be used by the front-end web applications to visualize them using frameworks like D3JS, recharts, stats and charts, etc. I've covered both of those approaches in my earlier videos, links of which you can find in my channel. I prefer structured JSON as it gives us more flexibility and options to visualize the data in the front-end. With that goal, let's go ahead and add a chart generator agent. I'll modify the system prompt for the researcher that its output is going to be used by the chart generator, and it might be required to do additional research in case the chart generator asks it to do so. I also added the instruction to make one tool call at a time and wait for the response to come back before making another tool call. It's because I noticed that although multiple tool calls were being generated by the Gemini model, while getting the responses back simultaneously, it would result in an error. I believe it is a bug with the implementation of the Chat Google Generative AI class that LangGraph needs to fix. I have also asked it to modify the search query as it goes on, something a human doing the research would also probably do. I'll create another React agent called Chart Generator. It will use the same LLM instance of Google Generative AI. I'll give it a system prompt where it can ask questions back to the researcher by including this key in the response, and finally output a JSON representing the charts like bar chart, pie chart, etc. I'll give it a JSON validator tool as well so that it can make sure that the output is a valid JSON object. This is a Python function that tries to load the parsed string as a JSON object. I'll define a graph state that has a messages key. The agents will write on this state to communicate information between themselves. I'll create a workflow, add these two nodes to the workflow, add an edge from the start to the researcher node and one from researcher to the chart agent, and add a conditional edge from the chart agent back to the researcher in case more information is asked for by the chart generator. I've gone through these steps in detail in my last video if you want to check that out. Now I'll test. I'll ask compare US and Chinese economy, and first the researcher gathers the data and summarizes the data under specific chart types, and then chart agent springs into action and outputs a structured JSON that is ready to be consumed by the visualization frameworks like D3, D charts, etc. Watching your own AI agent spin up to work is actually pretty cool. Even better is the fact that now you know how to build something that can be useful using large language models. Let's go over what we did. We installed LangGraph Studio, wrote a simple AI agent, and watched it work. This shows how easy it is to start working with LLMs and integrate them in agentic workflows. Repeating these steps with little tweak here and there, you can make even more advanced agents. If you like this tutorial, leave a comment about what you have learned and what you'd like to see next. Don't forget to like, subscribe, and be sure to check out my other videos for more fun AI projects. Thanks for watching and happy developing.